Hey everyone, welcome to lesson 2. Now that you know what makes a great logo, the next question is, how do you actually make one? Many beginners make a huge mistake. They jump straight onto the computer and start clicking around. That almost always leads to a generic, weak designs that lack thoughts and strategy. True professionals follow a structured process. It saves time, reduces frustration, and leads to far more creative and effective result. In this lesson, I'll walk you through 6-step logo design process from a blank page to a finished vector file. Step number 1 is the brief and the research. This is your foundation. You can't design in a vacuum. You need to ask questions. And the questions are, who is the client? Who is their target audience? What are their values? And what are their competitors? This stage isn't about drawing. It's about listening and understanding the business and doing research about their industry. And this is how you ensure your design is appropriate. You have to go and do the research about the industry and collect as much as information you want for the brand. Once you understand the brief and done your research, the next step is mind mapping and brainstorming. Now we start generating ideas. Take the keywords from your brief. Let's say the client is Eco Heaven. So in the center of the page, write it down and radiate out every related word you think about. For example, if you think about Eco Heaven, Eco and Heaven, you think about like green, home, leaf, tree, nature to roots, growth, and then recycle, then wood, then shelter to nature. And that way, think more ideas about it and write down on your page just like this. So you have to know that no idea is a bad idea here. You have to jot down all the ideas you have in your mind. Whatever logo idea you have to just put it in the center and think of all the related word or that centers around that logo and just create a mind map. This visual brainstorming session creates a pool of concepts to draw from, setting you up for a memorable and meaningful design. And that will help you in your next step, that is sketching. So the next step is sketching, the most important step. This is where all the magic happens. You have to put away your computer and grab your pencil and paper. The goal here is not to draw a perfect thing. Yeah, you have to explore dozens of ideas quickly and loosely. So take your pencil and paper and jot down all the ideas you have in your mind, like looking at your brainstorming ideas, the words, think of that word, and whatever image comes to your mind, just draw it out on your page. You can jot down all your ideas you have in your mind and just draw out the sketch roughly. Think simplicity in form. Don't judge, just create. Quantity over quality is must. And here are some of the sketch examples we have shown here. These are the sketches for the logos, rough sketches. And this freedom is how you discover unexpected, unique, and timeless concepts that you did never find by staring at a blank Illustrator page. Next step is refinement. The step number 4 is refinement. So now you evaluate. Look over all your sketches and think which one best fit the brief and the 5 principles we have learned earlier. Then circle out top 2 to 3 concepts you like. And over a new page, redraw these selected ideas with more care and details. clean up the lines, define the shapes, and think about balance and proportion. This refined sketch becomes your blueprint, the clear guide you'll use for your next step. So here are all the refined logo sketches for our logo eco heaven. And now we'll go to the next step, that is step number 5, digitization. Now we'll open the Illustrator. And we're not starting from scratch as we already have the blueprint of our tracing. So we'll place a scan of your refined sketch onto a template layer. We'll lower the opacity. We're going to use all the tools, for example, the pen tool, the shapes tool, and the pathfinder tool to build your logos with a clean, scalable vector shapes. So this is the way you do your digitization of your logo. Just place your final refined sketch and trace it out using all the necessary tools from the Illustrator, and make sure it's very simple, it's clear and refined so that it can be scaled. And this is where you ensure technical perfection and versatility, making sure every corner point is perfect so it can be scaled from a billboard to a favicon without losing any quality. Here are some examples of the final logo designs. Now we'll go to the next step, that is step number 6, presentation and delivery. This is very important. How you present your work is crucial. A logo in the center of a blank page is uninspiring. So instead, present it in a context. Show it on the mockups. For example, a business card, a mobile app icon, a store sign, a coffee cup, and much more. And here are some of the examples for presentation of the logo. You can download mockups, which is available, and place your logo in it and present it to your clients so that they can know how their logo is going to look in the real case scenario. This demonstrates its versatility and help the client visualize their brand potential. And it shows you haven't just designed a mark, you have designed a system. In our next 2 lessons, we're going to see this entire process in action with a real case study. Designing a logo for a coffee shop called Bloom and Brew. And we'll start with a brief and take it all the way to the finished vector mark. So there they are, your 6 essential steps for logo design process. The brief and research. Mind mapping and brainstorming, sketching, refinement, digitization, and presentation and delivery. For our next step, I want you to pick a fictional company, a coffee shop, a tech startup, or a gym, and just do steps from 1 to 3. Write a brief for yourself, do a mind map, and fill a page with sketches. Get comfortable with the thinking part. I'll see you in the next lesson.